1st of March 2017, I started my first job as a programmer in Chicago. After 2 years of asking dumb questions about Git and Vim, I moved to Seattle to join Amazon in July of 2019. The pressure is intense, and within the first month, I break production servers. After 2 years filled with countless mistakes and learnings, I joined Google in April of 2021. But this journey was far from easy. I had to learn many different technologies and made several mistakes over the last 6 years. In today's video, I'll share ups and downs of my last 6 years, the heartache, the frustration, and the triumphs. I'll also share how my salary changed over these 6 years. So buckle up and join me on this wild ride through the world of tech. The year is 2016 and I'm about to graduate from college. Despite all my friends begging me to learn programming for the sake of my career, I have decided to take the job market head on and find a job as a mechanical engineer. I apply for many jobs, but all I hear is crickets. Left with no choice, I started learning Java. I believed that as an engineer, learning programming would be straightforward. In reality, I could not be more wrong. I struggled to get used to the syntax of Java. How do you make sense of public static void main string args as a beginner? Still makes my skin crawl to this day. Anyway, like any other noob, I spent months trying to learn every single detail of Java. I mean, what was I trying to do learning iterators and comparators at that stage? This was first of 4 big mistakes I made in my 6 years. After learning Java, I made some basic projects to give my resume some credibility. To pad my resume further, I also added some machine learning projects that I built using R language. Right when I thought I was ready to find a job, I learned a harsh truth about a programmer's life. After learning the basics, every programmer needs to take 2 separate paths simultaneously. In the first path, the programmer is learning specialized skills and building projects. In the second path, programmer masters data structures and algorithms and does lead code to prepare for coding interviews. There is some overlap between these paths, but for the most part, they are separate. If you do it right, you will be able to get a job. But in the process, life will give you the finger. Not preparing for interviews early enough was the second big mistake I made. After solving hundreds of problems on lead code, I started applying for jobs. I was not getting many interviews, but a few that I did get, I was getting rejected left, right, and center. When I asked recruiters for the feedback, they told me the harsh truth that I didn't want to hear. You have no industry experience. But this is going to be my first entry-level job after college, I argued. What kind of experience are you expecting? And that's when I learned about the third mistake I had made. And that is, I did not do any internships. In my case, I started learning programming very late in college. But if you're in your second or third year, I highly recommend doing internships. Anyway, after hustling for 4 months, I got 2 offers. First was an internship at a good company where I would get to work on a modern tech stack. Second was a full-time job in a fintech company where I would be mostly using legacy systems. As an international student in the US, I could not do an internship after graduation. So I chose the second option and took the full-time job where I was making around $70,000. And that was mistake number 4. We will talk about this in detail, but to summarize, it was very hard for me to recover from a bad first job. If you are in the same situation as me, I recommend that you keep trying and don't give up until you get a good first job where you get to learn new technologies. Because once you start working on legacy code bases, it's gonna be very hard to convince your next employer to bet on you. And the expectations are much lower for new grads when compared to industry hires. Anyway, I moved to Chicago and started working at this fintech company. And this is where I entered the darkest 2 years of my life. I hardly remember this part of my life because it still feels like a nightmare. When I decided to make a career in software engineering, I wanted to see what it's like to work with the top people in the industry and learn from them. And here I was working on legacy code from the 80s, which was nothing but giant blocks of if-else statements dumped into monolithic files. Within the first 2 weeks, I knew that if I wanted to get to good places, I need to learn new skills outside work hours and keep honing my interviewing skills. So I would reach work at 9 a.m. sharp. I would use the lunch hour to hit the gym so that my evenings are free. I would come back home at 5 and have my first meal of the day. My eating habits were so bad that at some point, I ate Domino's for 6 months straight and lost 40 pounds in the process. I should be made the poster boy for Domino's for my weight loss. After having my meal, I would start coding and go on until 1 or 2 a.m. in the morning. I did this for 2 years straight and learned skills like web development and Android development in the process. I also solved another 250 problems on lead code. I felt much more confident now and started applying for jobs. To my surprise, nobody was ready to hire me because I could not sell my work experience in the job market. After 6 months of job hunting, I was so heartbroken that I wanted to go back home to India to see my family and come back and start all over again. When I brought this up at work, They pressurized me into not going back. They were subtle about it, but it was clear what they meant. Anyway, I was stuck in a meaningless job with no future prospects, and no matter how hard I tried, I was getting nowhere. Even though my confidence was shattered, deep down, I knew that this too shall pass. So I went back to the job market and started applying again. This time I was lucky and got an offer from Amazon. Amazon offered me around $200,000. So I packed my bags and moved to Seattle in July of 2019. My journey as a professional programmer truly began with my role in Amazon personalization team. I spent most of my time coding in Java and Python here. My main job was to build data pipelines and machine learning models for product recommendations on Amazon. We would then test these recommendations with users using A/B testing and collect data to decide whether to launch them. Although the job was demanding, I loved every minute of it because I got to own my projects from start to finish. What I valued the most from my experience at Amazon was the emphasis on putting the user first, which is something that I always keep in mind when making my YouTube videos. Every second counts, so I make sure that every second is valuable to my viewers. If you're enjoying what you see, hit the subscribe button to join the community. But like they say, all good things must come to an end. In April 2021, I left Amazon to join Google. I was making more than $300,000 now, but more importantly, I was working at what many consider to be one of the best companies of our time. I worked for Google Search in my first year and later moved to Google Assistant to learn some new technologies. For those who are curious, I have been mostly coding in C++ here. Working at Google gave me the first-hand experience of watching excellence in action. From my colleagues to the internal tools to the way people are managed here, everything at Google exudes excellence. Looking back, I can confidently say that all the struggles were worth it. If there is one thing I want you to take away from my journey, it's this. Everything will be okay in the end. If it's not okay, it's not the end. If you're feeling pumped to start your own programming journey and want to learn about 3 programming roadmaps that will make your life easier than mine, watch this video. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.